He's staying up late to be on the podcast. He's a trooper.
Absolutely. So that we can talk about Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Pokemon Let's Go Eevee, which is very, very exciting. So you flew out to where, Suriel? Give me the journey of your trip.
We went to, it was similar to the path we took for the Dragon Ball cover story, where we went to Narita Airport and then we went to, took like a 1 hour bus ride over to Tokyo. But yeah, we went to Tokyo and we kind of were just here to watch this one press conference. And then we had, a Q&A with, Masuda. They had after the press conference, they had this initial, Q&A with multiple people on the team behind the press conference. And I think that was mostly Japanese press. We didn't ask any questions then. And then we were led to another room where we talked to Masuda with like a small group of American press.
Okay, stop. I feel like we're missing the baseline. You went to Creatures, the developer?
We're going there tomorrow.
Oh, really? Oh, fascinating. Okay. So then today you were just in some generic place for this press conference.
Yeah, we went to a very fancy live conference area where there were just rows of what I imagine are Pokemon Company employees all standing at attention, like no one was leaning on the walls or anything. It was very, very formal.
Bunch of Nurse Jennies out there, yeah.
They take it very seriously over there.
Yeah, everyone was in a suit. So.
Okay, give me the biggest impression. What was the vibe of the room? Was it like, hey, we're trying something weird? Or was it like, hey, everybody, kind of sort of Pokemon RPG on Switch?
Yeah, everyone seemed very convinced that this was like some sea change. Everyone was very excited about sort of revealing this new thing. It seemed very, like, it didn't seem like they were holding back in terms of like, I don't know, like maybe don't get your hopes up. Like it seemed like they were very adamant about sort of the impact this might have.
Yeah. So. Okay, Kyle, what the hell did they announce? Let's get to it here.
So Let's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee, which is, it kind of bridges the gap between Pokemon Go and like a Pokemon console game. And it's also a little bit of a remake of Yellow, but it's simplified in a way, focused towards younger kids.
That's exactly it. Okay, yeah. What I want to know, can I pop a champagne bottle? Is this the Pokemon RPG on Switch that I want it to be? Because watching that trailer, I'm feeling really good about it. And they say it's like, oh, it's your first journey, your first adventure. You can play it with one hand. But everything in that trailer looks pretty damn good to me. Can I be excited? No!
Of course.
Okay, Suriel, are you excited?
This to me feels like the Pokemon RPG that they are setting up as sort of the bridge between like, hey, I've heard about Pokemon. I play Pokemon Go and then kind of fell off of it. But I remember that Pokemon was cool. So then I think this game is for that person of just like, oh yeah, this is sort of like a very simple RPG that I can get into. That sort of reminds me of those old games that I used to play when I was young.
Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to channel the listeners right there and the viewers out there that might be in this camp. Maybe it's just cause I'm in this camp, but love the Pokemon RPG games, especially Red and Blue. Pokemon Go. It was novel for a little while. I now think I actively dislike the concept of Pokemon Go.
Which is frustrating to me, by the way, but we can get into that.
How many years has it been out? No battling and no trading. That's just deal over. I'm not playing that crap again.
This has battling and trading.
That's exactly
it. So it's basically, yeah.
Well, what I want to know is like, what is Pokemon Go about it? And should that scare off the RPG fans if they're not won over by Pokemon Go?
I think the most major difference that I think a lot of mainline RPG players for the Pokemon series are going to notice is the way catching works.
Yeah.
So it's basically identical to Pokemon Go in that it is more involved. There aren't battles with wild Pokemon. Instead, it just goes to the Pokemon Go capture screen. But there are trainer battles, so you do fight other trainers.
That's really bizarre. And we should point out this is all in Kanto. And so in theory, they said they recreated that entire world?
Yeah, they talked about how it will be the Kanto landmass, but like you'll see things that are reminiscent of like, hey, you'll recognize parts of it, but it'll like, they obviously said that, hey, it'll be very different in terms of like, you know, it's not like a pixel per pixel recreation.
Okay.
It seems like they are trying to channel that spirit of Pokemon, you know, Red and Blue and Yellow.
Yeah. And even in one of the early leaks, before this game was announced, and it seemed to be 100% spot on now, they talked about like HMs, are still like Pokemon moves. You can ride Pokemon around.
Are HMs in the game, Suriel?
They are not. So there are no HMs. So I think it'll be very similar to Sun and Moon in that basically you used like different Pokemon to or maybe they could just remove that stuff entirely. Just like, hey, no blockades. If you want to go somewhere, we'll either time gate it or you just go wherever.
The leak
point.
Said it was like Sun and Moon, so I'll trust that since it was right about absolutely everything else. And also the leak said that you will encounter Red and Blue in the storyline somewhere in this game, which is really interesting. Did they talk about that at all, or like where the story's set?
They didn't say anything other than it'll be later in the... It's not going to be a recreation of the story of Red and Blue, and that it won't take you to Johto at all. So there's not going to be like the whole, you know, back half of Gold and Silver.
Which they got to save
that. I like that a lot. Yeah. Yeah. Maybe that's my favorite thing about it.
Yeah. Let's Go Don Fan, I think, is going to be coming out later, and everybody can really look forward to that one.
I mean, I think it is worth noting. I don't know if we made this clear up front that this is like a simplified, different version of the Pokemon RPG that they teased at E3. They were very explicit about that.
Yes, yeah.
This is like a younger audience focus, new to Pokemon. Like, it's going to be a simplified version of it. And that RPG that they teased at E3, they announced, well, I guess announced in quotes, they kind of just had it in the press release, that it's coming late 2019 now.
So that is the Game Freak next generation RPG for the Switch.
Yes.
What I want to know
is... Game Freak did develop this one.
I thought Creatures made this.
No, it's Game Freak, right, Suriel?
They're helping. Yeah, they're helping with this, but this is Game Freak.
Yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Masuda is on this.
Oh, really? I knew that because I know that Pokemon Quest, which we'll talk about in a little bit, I know that was all Game Freak, but that's interesting because the look of Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee, I think it has a great look, and it looks very Detective Pikachu.
I like the way it looks a lot. I think it looks really cool.
But it looks like those Detective Pikachu models, which Creatures was developing.
See, I thought it looked more like the Go models.
Yeah, I think it looks like up-res the Pokemon Go models at this point.
Yeah.
The Pidgey that I saw was like recognizably the Pidgey in Pokemon Go.
Okay. Well, that now it makes me wonder even more. I mean, this is what the new game's probably going to look like. Maybe some animation tweaks. Obviously, the art completely different in terms of the setting and the, you know, geography. But in theory, the Pokemon real RPG coming next year, it's going to look like this, right?
I think it'll be less chibi. I don't know if you could even describe this as being that kind of chibi cute look.
I think it's fairly like chibi-ish, and like your main character is very like very exaggerated portions in a way that I don't think like mainline Pokemon games are.
Because they said specifically that the 2019 one is going to be more like XY, Sun and Moon, and those designs are getting more realistic.
Wait, what do you mean? What do they say specifically?
So basically, they said that this is sort of like them looking at the Switch as a console in terms of like from what we saw, it didn't seem like the handheld mode was the way to play this game just because you will have to use the gyro sensor to aim when you're trying to catch Pokemon.
Right.
And they view sort of the 2019 games as them looking at the Switch as a portable and continuing the 3DS basically lineage with those
that
games.
Has me worried about is that like graphical fidelity at all, or what exactly does that mean? Because in this game you can still like trade and battle online and stuff, right, in the Let's Go Pikachu?
Yeah, that was one of the more unclear things, because they mentioned that they won't be using Nintendo's online service, but in a Q&A they did go back and say like, yeah, you'll be able to trade and battle, you know, through local play and through Wi-Fi, which is basically what Nintendo always says when they mean online. So you will have that online infrastructure, I believe. But it seems weird from that standpoint.
Okay, what I'm still trying to figure out is what's watered down here. So you can't fight Pokemon in the wild, which seems like a real bummer. So at that point, then it's like, well, you can't really grind, can't really train. You can still battle trainers and probably level up. I saw you can select moves and stuff. Like that seems good. But what else do you think is going to be watered down? What's going to disappoint fans is what I'm trying to figure out.
There's no random battles in grass. You'll see the Pokemon walking around in the grass. They haven't finalized how experience works. So there's a chance that whenever you catch a Pokemon, you'll gain experience for your entire party, or it could just be whatever Pokemon you have selected. And then you'll also gain experience from, you know, Pokemon battles. They also mentioned that you can't evolve, your starter Pokemon. So you'll be stuck with, you can send Eevee or Pikachu out of your party, but you can't evolve that specific Pokemon, but you can catch, you know, more other Pikachus or Eevees and evolve those instead.
That's really wild. So it is strangely Pokemon Yellow in that way, which is a fun reference point for this entire project. Okay, so you can also, I saw in the trailer, you can have like other Pokemon follow you around, so you can catch in theory 151 and have them follow you around.
So all the footage we saw only had one Pokemon following you around, so it's hard to know how long that conga line goes.
Well, no, I just mean of all the different options. Like, I can have a Mewtwo walking around behind me if I want.
Yes, and then if they're large enough, like in the trailer there was an Onix, you'll ride them, and then Pikachu will also be riding on your back.
That's so cute. Kyle, are you excited for this?
I am, but I do think it's going to be more of a spin-off than I think we're
realizing.
But
if the spin-off is an RPG, even if it's a simplified one that recreates all of Kanto with all 100, like original 151, that's a good game.
Yes, I'm excited for this, but I think it's going to be really simple. I think it's going to be kid-focused, which isn't a bad thing.
But what does simple mean? That's what I'm still trying to figure out.
Less statistics, less reading, less like management. You're just
fewer items, probably.
You're just catching Pokemon and you're sort of building your team, and I think that's the most fun part of it is like you're building a team, and it's going to be based in this familiar Pokemon world that you played in Yellow specifically.
Right.
But yeah. I don't think it's going to feel like a core Pokemon RPG.
It's going to feel more like it than, you know, Gale of Darkness or any of that nonsense, you know?
Well,
I don't know. It is more of a Pokemon game than that. But like, I think that one of the other questions we asked during the Q&A was, they're not going to emphasize sort of IVs and stats and sort of like all the sort of under the hood stuff that has kind of come to define sort of, you know, high level Pokemon play over the years. I think they're going to shift away from that and sort of simplify it. And I think this ends up being the Pokemon RPG that Pokemon Go fans want. I like Pokemon Go. I like, you know, seeing all those creatures again, but there's not much to this game. I wish I could just play a game like the ones I remember. And I think this is that game for them. I don't think this necessarily like means that hardcore Pokemon games aren't going to like it. I just think that if you've been playing the games all along, this isn't going to feel like one of those to you.
Sure.
And like, I just don't think it's going to be like, oh man, Pokemon on Switch, finally. It's not going to be that game. It's going to be, I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited about it. I like the way it looks. Me and Suriel both, we still play a lot of Pokemon Go. I like that communication between the two games. So I'm looking forward to it. But I don't think it's going to be the sort of revelation of Pokemon on a console that we're hoping
I think it's
for.
A huge leap forward. I think it's going to scratch a big itch for at least a year before the big new thing comes out. But there's a twisted part of me where I'm such a nostalgia hound with Pokemon that like, kind of more excited for this maybe than like a new generation of new freaks, especially if graphically it looks the same.
It's very focused on the original group of 150, which a quick aside, Cyril, that you tweeted, which I thought was really funny, is the fact that you can ride any Pokemon that's a certain size. Apparently they said that they toyed with the idea of being able to ride any Pokemon, which I really love that they
and then
sat
they
there
abandoned it,
like rubbed their chins going like, what if you could ride Pikachu around?
Just like a little Dratini between your legs.
That'd be amazing.
So stupid.
I think they made a mistake there. I would have loved to see
other interesting things. Co-op. You can run around, catch a Pokemon with another person, which is very confusing exactly how that works and whatnot. Also, they're releasing a Pokeball Joy-Con. Help me with this, Suriel.
So it's the Pokeball Plus, which is basically the sequel to the Pokemon Go Plus.
Okay.
So this will work basically like one like that in Go, but in Let's Go, it'll function as basically your Joy-Con in that you'll use it to catch Pokemon and you know, interface with the game for the most part. I think they said that it'll completely replace it and that you can play the game with just a Joy-Con. So you may be able to just play the entire game with that Pokeball.
That's so weird.
Does it have a joystick on it? You did get to hold it, right?
I don't know. Like, no, I wasn't able. They would not let us hold it. So it's hard to know if that is going to be a joystick.
In the video, it certainly looks like it. Like the Pokeball button looks like a joystick. Yeah.
So the other thing is that it's sort of like it has PokeWalker functionality a little bit because you can put a Pokemon in the Pokeball and then walk around with it in real life, and you know they'll give you bonuses based on that. Like what those are, it's hard to know.
And they said you can feel the Pokemon inside of it, which I thought it was going to be like HD Rumble, but I don't know if that thing has HD Rumble or not. But I guess you can feel Eevee walking around in there.
Is it true? Can you feel Eevee walking around in there, Suriel?
They said they are incorporating Rumble into it. So like they talked a little bit about how they want it. They want sort of the action of, you know, pretending to throw a Pokeball to feel good as you're throwing it, and that they work very hard on it.
So Eevee will be jostling around.
Oh God. Boink, 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 boink.
I think it'd be funny if that's what you had to do to catch the Pokemon instead of just clicking the button. So they're, you know, people walking around just kind of like doing this action every few feet as they're walking around.
Well, here's the crucial question. Can I put some sort of elastic strap onto it so that when I catch Pokemon while playing the game, I can actually chuck the ball and then it'll come back to me like a fun yo-yo?
You might be like, it comes with a wrist strap, and it also comes with like a ring that I think you can put on your finger to prevent it from even sliding out of your hand. So, I mean, if you want to modify
what fun.
It,
This is so strange. It's so crazy to think about Pokemon, like the Pokemon company, Game Freak, apparently a little bit, but I'm skeptical of how involved they are. I bet they're like offering support and maybe a couple things here and there, but I hope to God they're mainly focusing on the new game. But anyways, it's fascinating to think of like Pokemon Company and Game Freak and Creatures wrapping back around and adapting to Pokemon Go in such a strange way. And obviously it's a phenomenon. It's still ranking in Buco Dolores,
all
as
the
they
money,
say.
I think
yeah,
that's what it is.
Yeah, absolutely. But to think that all came from an April Fool's Day joke with Google. And now because of that weird joke, now it has forever shaped the first console RPG for Pokemon. It's insane.
It's weird.
It's a weird world, Suriel, and you're seeing it firsthand, man.
Yeah. It's also like I was not expecting these games to be out this year, but it seems like they very quickly saw Pokemon Go and said like we need to make a game based around this before this thing, you know, either dies out or
frankly, guys, I think they're all in it for the money.
I think it's the right call. Like I'm thankful for them that they said like, by the way, the sort of, you know, hardcore RPG that's still in the way. But I think it is absolutely the right call to capitalize on Pokemon Go's popularity and wrap it into the larger game.
And not with a cheap cash. At least from the trailer, it looks like a couple notches above just slamming Pokemon Go on Switch.
I think so.
Yeah. Okay.
They also could have just said, like, hey, let's make the next core RPG basically like Pokemon Go. So I think, like, the fears of, like, oh, Pokemon Go is going to make these games worse, I think, is a little bit assuaged by, like, hey, we have this thing for Pokemon Go players, but we also have, you know, the next set.
It just made this one worse. Yeah, yeah. That was just a clip from a larger show called The Game Informer Show. You can find it on iTunes, Google Play, or GameInformer.com. We take the fun opportunities and exclusive information from Game Informer Magazine and boil it into a show that airs every Thursday with exclusive cover story information, developer interviews, a lot of fun stuff. So come love games with us.